Welcome everyone. It is good to be here with you. Today we are closing our Christmas series and we are going to look at what happened when the wise men came from afar to see baby Jesus. But first, let's worship the Lord and sing together.
And heaven and heaven and nature sing.
J to the O to the Y. I got the J to the O.
Go Fish guys, I have the perfect part for you and all the kids to sing. Now I'm gonna sing it, and you and the kids just sing it back to me. You ready? All right, here we go. Hey, you sing.
Little baby here among us.
job, everybody.
Last week, our memory verse was Luke 2, verse 14. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to those with whom God is pleased. Today, our memory verse is Matthew 2, verse 2. We have come to worship Him. Please say it with me. Matthew 2, verse 2. We have come to worship Him. Let's sing one more song together. Christmas is fun and exciting. What is one of the fun parts about Christmas? That's right, getting presents. I love presents, don't you? Can you tell me why we give each other presents at Christmas? Yes, we give each other presents because we love each other and because we want to make the people we love happy. But there's another reason too. We give presents at Christmas because we remember that the wise men gave presents to baby Jesus when they found him. Last week we heard about the angels that made a special announcement about the birth of Jesus to the shepherds. Today we are going to learn about the wise men that came from far to meet baby Jesus. We read about it in Matthew 2, verse 1 to 12. Please watch this video with me to see what happened.
The story of Christmas, Jesus and the wise men. This is Jesus.
Hoo-yah!
Jesus is the Son of God who would grow up to do amazing things. His parents on earth were Mary and Joseph.
Hey-o.
Jesus was born in a barn because there was no room for him anywhere else in Bethlehem. Bethlehem was part of Judea, an area that was ruled by a king named Herod. King Herod was in Jerusalem when some wise men from eastern lands arrived in Jerusalem asking,
"Excuse me,
where is the newborn king of the Jews? We saw his star as it rose and we have come to worship him." When Herod heard that there was another king born in Judea, he was very upset, as was everyone else in Jerusalem.
Yeah, not you.
So Herod called all the important priests and Jews together and asked them where this king was supposed to be born. The Jews knew that their king would eventually come, and it was always told to them that the king of the Jews, the savior of the world, would be born in Bethlehem. So they told that to King Herod. Then King Herod thought of a way to trick the wise men. So he called a private meeting with them and learned from them when the king of the Jews' star first appeared.
Oh, good!
And then King Herod told the wise men, go to Bethlehem and search carefully for the child. And when you find him, come back and tell me so that I can go and worship him too.
Okay. Hey, on your way.
But secretly, Herod wanted to know where the king of the Jews was so he could get rid of him. So the wise men went on their way, and the star they had seen in the east guided them to Bethlehem. It went ahead of them and stopped over the place where Jesus was, and the wise men were filled with joy.
Woohoo!
They went into the house and saw Mary and Jesus.
Hello!
Oh, look! Wow!
And they bowed down and worshiped Jesus.
Wait!
They gave him special gifts fit for the king that he was, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Then God warned them in a dream to not go home through Jerusalem, where King Herod was, but God told them to go home a different way. So they did. And then an angel appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, get up. The angel told Joseph to go to Egypt with Mary and Jesus because Herod was looking to kill Jesus. That very night, Joseph left for Egypt with Jesus and Mary. They stayed in Egypt until Herod was gone, and it was safe for them to go home to Israel. When they returned, an angel warned them about the new ruler of Judea, who was Herod's son.
This way.
So Joseph and his family went to the region of Galilee and found their new home in the town of Nazareth.
Look good?
Yep.
We'll take it.
Where Jesus would grow up and eventually do all the amazing things God had planned for him to do.
What can we learn from today's story? We give gifts to each other at Christmas because we remember the gifts that the wise men gave to baby Jesus. We also remember that the best gift of all is Jesus. Jesus is God's gift to us. Let us pray and thank God for giving us this wonderful gift. Dear God, thank you for giving us this wonderful gift. Thank you for sending us Jesus, your one and only Son. Thank you for Christmas. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We are closing our lesson with one more song. Please sing with me.
Oh,
You know I have time to do the activities that goes with this lesson. May God bless you. Goodbye.